Hello, welcome to our YouTube channel. If you are new here, please subscribe. This is another video presentation featuring a question on corporation law asked in the 2014 bar exams. The question was, pursuant to its bylaws, SOAA Corporation's Board of Directors created an executive committee to manage the affairs of the corporation in between board meetings. The Board of Directors appointed the following members of the Executive Committee: the President, Sarah L., the Vice President, Jane L., and a third member from the Board, Juan Riles. On December 1, 2013, the Executive Committee, with Sarah L. and Jane L. present, met and decided on the following matters. 1. Purchase of a delivery van for use in the corporation's retail business. 2. Declaration and approval of the 13th month bonus. 3. Purchase of an office condominium unit at the fort, and 4. Declaration of 10 pesos per share cash dividend. Are the actions of the executive committee valid? This clever question is about the executive committee, its composition and limitations on its power. The problem states that the executive committee was composed of the president, clearly a director, the vice president, who may or may not be a director, and another member of the board. But in the meeting when the question decisions were made, only two were present. The rule pertaining to an executive committee of a corporation is as follows. If the bylaws so provide, the board may create an executive committee composed of at least three directors. Said committee may act, by majority vote of all its members, on such specific matters within the competence of the board, as may be delegated to it in the bylaws or by majority vote of the board, except with respect to the A. approval of any action for which shareholders' approval is also required, B. filling of vacancies in the board, C. amendment or repeal of bylaws or the adoption of new bylaws, D. amendment or repeal of any resolution of the board which by its express terms is not amendable or repealable, and E. distribution of cash dividends to the shareholders. The Board of Directors may create special committees of temporary or permanent nature and determine the members' term, composition, compensation, powers, and responsibilities. The requirement is clear: members of the Executive Committee should all be members of the Board of Directors. In case there is no question as to the qualifications of the members of the Executive Committee, only the decision to declare cash dividend is not valid because all the rest are within the powers of the executive committee unless there is a contrary provision in the bylaws or in the resolution creating the executive committee. The suggested answer is, the actions made by the executive committee are all invalid because it was not made by majority vote of all members of the committee. There is also a question if Jane L. is a director because it is required that all members of the executive committee are all members of the board of directors. All the decisions except the declaration of cash dividend should have been valid if there were no question on the vote requirement and Jane L.'s qualification. We hope you learned something useful in this video. Thank you. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel and like our Facebook page ECS Notes. You may also comment and share this video to your friends. Have a pleasant day.